ever and ever.
What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Critical Overlord here. So this is just going to be my review for the sequel to Stanley Kubrick's, as well as Stephen King's one of his best-selling novels, The Shining. As we all know, I did make a video previously discussing how it was receiving early praise. And of course, now that I've seen the film for myself, I can see that the praise is warranted, because the Doctor's Sleep, while it's not as good as The Shining, and it's not going to be as horrific to some as The Shining, it is a well-made companion to that story. And somehow Mike Flanagan managed to make a film that kind of just, it kind of balances out, and it does everything it needs to kind of be a sequel to Kubrick's film, recognize the novel The Shining, and then also recognize the novel that is Dr. Sleep. I would say for the first two-thirds of the movie, that's the strongest, and then the third act is gonna be amazing for a lot of fans of The Shining. But then it does stumble a bit, has a few hiccups there, and then it feels a bit rushed. But other than that, this was a very good movie. First of all, I want to talk right off the bat about Rebecca Ferguson. She is an absolute treat as Rose the Hat. She's very seductive in the role, very charming, very charismatic, and she just brings like a new, she's based off what I've read, because I haven't fully read the novel of Dr. Sleep. I still have a few pages, but she perfectly embodies that character, in my opinion. She is an amazing actress. The way she talks, the way she walks, this vibe she gives off of her. Anytime she was talking, I was just listening. I was just hooked onto what she was saying. She has like this trance-like voice. Again, since Rebecca Ferguson is very, very attractive, the character of Rose the Hat now is very attractive. So, aside from that, the villain is also, Rose the Hat is very sadistic, she's very methodical, she is very sinister with what she wants to do, and her intentions are very sinister. She basically is the leader of this group known as the True Knot, who in this universe they exist. So also Dr. Sleep is expanding on what we already found out about The Shining and Danny Torrance and his Shining capability. It expands on all of that. And we find out that there's people in the world who feed off of this stuff. So in this particular story, this group of people are known as the True Knot, just a group of people who are quote unquote immortal, because what they do, they have abilities of their own. They're psychic individuals. What these people do is they feed off of the life source, or they feed off of the life of the people with the Shining ability, because what it does is it provides them youth and a longer lifespan. They are, in a sense, this world's vampires. And what I kind of appreciate is how what it's saying here is that the vampires, if vampires were real, or the vampires that we all know and love, they're based off of these real life individuals that feed off of the shine, and therefore they're immortal. They stay young forever. I like that. Other than that, Dr. Sleep, another few things it has working for it is Ewan McGregor, who stars as the grown-up Danny Torrance. In the film, basically set a few decades after The Shining, and we're following Danny, who is now grown up. He has sadly fallen into the same alcoholic habits of his father. He's still recovering from the events at the Overlook Hotel. We get to catch up with him, see the struggles he's been going through. And then he's also been in communication with a young girl that he becomes pen pals with, of sorts, once he decides that he wants to not go down that same dark road that his father went, and he wants to start new. He becomes pen pals of sort with a girl who he learns has the same abilities as he does to shine. Once she becomes the target of the True Knot, they team up, they seek to take down the True Knot. The movie is very enchanting. Mike Flanagan, he's one of the best directors out now. He has been someone who I've been paying attention to since he kind of broke out with the 2013 film Oculus. He managed to recover and save the Ouija horror series with a moderately decent sequel. Gerald's Game, he did. That was great. He hasn't done anything that's been received negatively, in my opinion, just yet. Not that I can recall. And then coming off the success of The Haunting of Hill House, which he also did for Netflix last year, this is just a great year for him. I think this is going to be his biggest hit for a film so far. So to make a sequel, a successful, worthy sequel, mind you, to one of the best horror films ever, that's going to be something that's going to set you apart from the rest of the directors out today. This is a big accomplishment for him. The score in Dr. Sleep is very unnerving. It's chilling. The Newton brothers do a great job at recreating certain tunes from The Shining. There's a particular scene towards the end where many fans who grew up with that film and know everything about The Shining, you're going to get chills sent down your spine. It's very nostalgic. Overall, this movie is just it's just an absolute blast. It's a love letter to The Shining. It's an imperfect love letter because it has several flaws, several things that prove why it is not better than The Shining. And then just the third act again is a bit clunky. But aside from that, Dr. Sleep, I'm going to have to give it a solid 7.5 out of 10. Oh, and another thing, the young actress in it, Abra. Abra is the girl that Danny befriends, the young girl that he befriends and helps to take down the True Knot with. The actress that plays her, she is one of the very few rare child actors who don't get on your nerves and you want to see more of the character. She is an absolute treat and a delight to see on screen. There's also a little bit of darkness to this character, so it's going to be interesting to see if this will even affect her later on in her life with her Shining capabilities. Of course, those are just some of the questions that we have to ponder after watching Dr. Sleep. Dr. Sleep, just like The Shining, leaves several things left unanswered, several things for you to wonder and ponder on. All in all, a very worthy expansion in this universe, a solid sequel to Stanley Kubrick's The Shining. It's just a beautiful film. Dr. Sleep is a 7.